on it.
Wow. As a final thought for the people who are watching this, and I'm somewhat in stunned silence just, you know, listening to what you're saying, because the power of the thoughts is, you know, shakes me to my core because of the implications it has in our, not just today, but in our future and future generations. So people are watching this now. What actions should they take? What do you think people should do? How can they activate?
We're going to beat these people. I feel, I've spent my life working on energy issues, environmental issues, and global warming and rivers. But I have taken a hiatus to do just this issue because I cannot stand by and watch these children be poisoned. You know, an entire generation of kids that is being poisoned now by, you know, government policies and greed, and we are going to take them on and beat them. And, you know, we need help. We're at the World Mercury Project. We need your support. We need financial support. We need members, because we're going to sue government agencies. We're going to sue pharmaceutical companies. We're suing the people. We're figuring out different ways to litigate this. But we need members in order to, for a charitable group to litigate, we need to show that we have members who have standing. Right. So, you know, we need everybody to join up, to go to our website and to join, and then, you know, write the president.
Right.
Write the president letters. I know that that President Trump actually is interested in this issue, and he reads people's letters who write him about this. Write him and write your member of Congress, and, you know, and write to your newspaper, and try to get them to start covering this issue, honestly.
So they can go to worldmercuryproject.org, and there they can sign up as a member, donate, and take
And we will also give you action alerts. We'll tell you things that you ought to be doing.
That's terrific. Well, can I just say, on behalf of myself and many, many other people who have a great interest in this issue, I want to thank you for all the work that you've done. I also want to thank you for letting us invade your home today and sit down and have this conversation with you and allow us to record it and to share it with others. It's been very, very meaningful, and I know it's going to make a difference, so thank you.
Thank you.
All right, so let's start out. Just to please introduce yourself and tell us what you do.
My name is Scott Miller. I'm a director. I come from a long list of filmmakers, if you will. My father's name is Warren Miller. He's done over 800 extreme sports movies. I shot a student film at Art Center College of Design that was qualified for an Academy Award in the short film category, which got me an honorary degree from Art Center. When I was at Art Center, we had great teachers. We had Ansel Adams, we had Francesca Scavullo, we had people of that ilk. And I was a fine artist at that school. I was not in the film business. And from there, I went to Wide World of Sports for a year, went around the world traveling, shooting sports films, and then realized that the movie business was something I really was going to relish as a director. And I moved into a very lucrative business in those days, which was high-end corporate image campaigns for commercials. And I did that for a number of years. Won all sorts of awards. Probably most of the clients that used to advertise you, and we did all of their stuff. We were very in demand. And this particular film bit me by accident.
So the original story that got this going, can you tell me what that story was?
Well, originally it was because it was, quite frankly, as a filmmaker, it was great drama. I didn't realize what I was getting myself into until we finished it and got such not a whiplash, but a whole bunch of information from military members.
I'm Melissa Mosich Miller. I'm Scott Miller's wife, and I'm the producer on this film, and I was also a writer and voiceover. You know, you have a visceral reaction to this kind of information and dealing with these kinds of stories because there's so much heartache. But there's another side to it, and that is how extraordinary our military personnel are. They're smart. They are interested in other people. They're generous, completely generous. They'd give their life. And so you have an obligation. And I approached the film, I my working with the film. I worked very closely with a researcher and associate producer, Bob Lee, to get information. And that information is fascinating. And you learn a lot in this film. I learned a lot, and I wanted the audience to learn a lot so that they can make their own decisions about things. So we have a very narrow group in military. You can watch it, you can know that it's the vaccine and that. But you have a big, broad pharmaceutical industry, military, government that is making these decisions. And they'll be making them for, you know, everybody, not just first responders like firemen and, you know, our Coast Guard and our, you know, all of our militaries. But they're going to be making them for all of us, for citizens. And we need to, what I wanted the film to show, and when we were working on the writing, I wanted people to see the process so they could see the thought processes that go into this. And unfortunately, one of the overriding thought processes is how can we make money off these things?
This one will tell the story, and it does tell the story right. It's the only film that I've really went out of my way to not manipulate.
This movie, Vaccine Syndrome, you get sent a lot of stuff. I get sent a lot of stuff. Saying no is like, you get inundated with it. So I'm automatically jaded. I see this come across. I get from Scott a link to see this film. Of course, I knew who Scott was as a filmmaker, but even still, it's just, there's no way to fit this in. I think I talked to you about it. It was like 10 o'clock at night. I start this. I'm going to watch 30 minutes of it and go to bed. I'll be able to say, yeah, I took a look at it. It doesn't really fit. I watched 30 minutes of it, and I was hooked. I watched, and literally an hour and a half later, I'm sitting at my counter in my kitchen at the island, tears streaming down my face. I had forgotten the military. We focused on the children, the mandatory vaccination program, but the other epicenter is the military, where we're vaccinating all of these, and we've got 18-year-old muscle-strong kids that are the healthiest kids in our country, and we're killing these kids. So I'm watching what they expose in this, the fraud and the corruption and the greed. It literally was jaw-dropping. And that night, I emailed you and said, guys, you have to look at this. It has to be a part of it. I really want to make sure that everybody in the country who knows anybody in the military, cares about anybody in the military, or cares about our military, sees this film. It's critically important. So it's why you and I are here. Why we shoehorned this into Vaccines Revealed is because it's that important that people see this.
Freedom. It is the soldier, not the reporter, who has given us the freedom of the press.
Got over 5,000 men from a force of 40,000 who are ill.
They kicked me out. It is the soldier, not the poet, who has given us the freedom of speech.
We're going on 40 some odd months now, non-stop, 24/7, screaming in my ears.
It is the soldier, not the campus organizer, who has given us the freedom to demonstrate.
It takes a few months to get before the effects of the anthrax vaccine really get going.
This is an experiment.
It is the soldier who serves beneath the flag.
I can't have Gulf War syndrome because I never actually went out to the Gulf.
There are no safe vaccines at all.
Whose coffin is draped by the flag.
For every one individual that comes forward, there are three individuals that will not.
Who salutes the flag.
My hands prevent me from operating.
My officers were right up there with God and Corps.
The inoculations I received are classified secret.
We had an inordinate amount of people who were sick.
Who allows the protester to burn the flag.
I have a real bad feeling on this.
It is the soldier, not the politician, who has given his blood.
I was no longer deployable because I would not take the vaccine.
His body.
All I know is I feel used and abused and left to rot in the streets.
His life. Freedom.
We are not the enemy.
He was proud of being a Marine. The Secretary of Defense says this is a lawful order. The entire chain of command, the Joint Chiefs say this is a lawful order.
They actually done this to us.
Yeah, we checked this out and we think it's a lawful order and we're not going to let it go to court.
If there was such a secret study being conducted that those responsible for it must be held accountable and it should never be allowed to happen again.
Use this as guinea pigs.
It is the soldier who serves beneath the flag, who salutes the flag, whose coffin is draped by the flag, who allows the protester to burn the flag.
Each man or woman would say, I was perfectly healthy.
Anthrax vaccine program ended my flying career.
And I took the anthrax vaccine and I immediately became ill.
Blood was coming out my nose, my ears, my bowels. And I was just too sick to do anything.
It is the soldier, not the politician, who has given his blood, his body, his life, who has given us these freedoms.
California, the worst measles outbreak in 15 years is spreading.
The virus is roaring back into the headlines tonight. An outbreak somehow traced to
someone who had probably caught measles abroad, visited Disneyland, and may have sneezed.
Measles on the march in America.
This outbreak is showing no signs of letting up. There are already more cases this year than there were.
The number tripled to 644 measles cases reported in 27 states.
And I mean, is this all basically because of the anti-vaccination movement? Because parents aren't vaccinating their kids?
Yeah, you know, I think so.
A bill that would ban exemptions from childhood vaccines is advancing through the California legislature.
We are authoring legislation that will abolish the personal belief exemption.
I think you're starting to see why it is that mandates are so important.
There has been some inaccurate information circulating about vaccines, mostly stemming from a British study linking vaccines to autism.
The bill requiring children to be vaccinated has passed with bipartisan support. Every child must meet immunization standards before joining public schools, private schools, and daycares.
I would strongly encourage everybody, look at the science, look at the facts. CDC, the Center for Disease Control, can give you good information. Get your children vaccinated.
I have waited a long time to tell my story, and I want to tell it truthfully. I was involved in deceiving millions of taxpayers regarding the potential negative side effects of vaccines. We lied about the scientific findings. The CDC can no longer be trusted to do vaccine safety work. Can't be trusted to be transparent. The CDC can't be trusted to police itself. Just a few thoughts. William W. Thompson, Senior Scientist, U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention.
Sitting at my desk where I teach at Simpson University, my phone rings, and it's Dr. William Thompson.
Brian, you and I don't know each other very well. I don't know how this is all going to play out. You have a son with autism, and I have great shame now when I meet families with kids with autism, because I have been part of the problem.
My son, Stephen, was born in February of 1998.
Steve,
What does the cow say?
Tweet, tweet.
Doggy.
Doggy?
Yeah. 2 weeks after his 15-month vaccines, then he lost all language. He lost all eye contact. You'd pick him up and he would just hang limp. Fast forwarding to 2014, Thompson said to me, Brian, if you listen to me, I can guarantee you will be able to access a treasure trove of data.
So I want to be a resource. I want to be valuable to you. I want you to have someone in the system.
For years, I had been trying to crack this edifice of the CDC and just getting little glimpses of what was not right.
The CDC has put the research 10 years behind. Because the CDC has not been transparent, we've missed 10 years of research because the CDC is so paralyzed right now by anything related to autism.